Welcome to this very important dialogue with Krishi Rishi Subhash Palekar on sustainable agriculture. Tell me something about the issue which is coming to very important as climate change, which is again was discussed.
Yeah.
The climate change and the whole thing is because the dangerous consequences of climate change, and people are seeing that we are irreversible, almost like unless we do something really significant on all fronts. But agriculture also contributes to this global warming or climate change. How does zero budget really help farming?
United Nations Organization has formed one international committee, that is IPCC, Intergovernmental Panel on Climate Change. And they have studied well what are the impact of the global warming climate change on human life and agriculture sector also, and environment also. Every 3 months, they are publishing a report. And they said that there is a great impact of the global warming and climate change on agriculture crop production, human health, and environment. And for that purpose, they have given some evidences also. What are the scientific evidence we can say? In my technology, there are 4 greenhouse gases are responsible for global warming and climate change. That is carbon dioxide, nitrous oxide, methane, and chlorofluorocarbon. Now, new generation of the CFC, that is hydrochlorofluorocarbon, SCFC. SCFC and CFC are the gift of the, that means Western type of the glorious and luxurious lifestyle. When you utilize AC cars and AC in the home and 3Gs and all these perfumes, you are responsible for the emitting the CFC gas. But initial 3, carbon dioxide, methane, nitrous oxide are emitted maximumly by 2 sectors, one agriculture sector and second one industry sector. In chemical farming, maximum greenhouse gases are emitted and organic farmers saw maximum greenhouse gases are emitted. I will give you an example. When you feed, give the chemical fertilizer to the soil, the chemical fertilizer residues are coming in the crops. And when chemically grown crops are, fodder are fed to the animals, the decomposition of the excreta, that means dung and urine, also emit maximum quantity of the nitrous oxide and methane and carbon dioxide. When human beings are eating chemically grown food material by means of the excreta of the human and urine, decomposition of this excreta and human urine, again, the greenhouse gases are emitted in large quantity. What the suggestions are given by the Agriculture Institute to burn the biomass, and the crop residue should be burned. And you will go to India and throughout the world, you've seen that in the harvesting period of paddy, wheat, and sugarcane, the huge smoke is emitted in the atmosphere because all the residues are burned. And these, while burning, this smoke means the greenhouse gases, carbon dioxide, methane, nitrous oxide. Even when you give the water, the Japanese method of paddy cultivation, when water is dumped in the soil and the residues of the previous crop are spoiled in the water, and methane is emitted in large quantity, and methane is going in the atmosphere. In sugarcane also, when you are giving maximum water, again methane is emitted. Even this Jersey Holstein foreign cow breeds also emitting maximum methane by their respiratory system. That means agriculture sector is the main responsible factor. Number one, input industries of the chemical farming and organic farming also emitting maximum greenhouse gases by means of smoke. And to build up the infrastructure of the agriculture universities and infrastructure of the chemical and organic farming, they want building material, and did building material input industry also emitting maximum quantity of the greenhouse gases. That means there is a chain. That means the agriculture sector is main responsible for greenhouse gases emission. And industry sector, what commodity we are utilizing in human being, are utilizing in daily needs, as a daily needs, so many things we can stop to utilization because it is not necessary at all. When, if you will stop this unnecessary utilization of the unnecessary commodities, actually, what has happened? The industry will be stopped. And when industry will be closed, ultimately, greenhouse gases emission will be stopped. In my zero budget farming, in organic farming, even when you spread out cow dung manure, farm and manure, FOM, and compost, vermicompost, all these manures are having 46% carbon. And when you spread out, and then when the temperature is going on above 36 degrees centigrade, and in India, 48 degrees centigrade in sowing period, and carbon is released, combined with oxygen in the atmosphere, and by means of oxidation of the carbon, carbon dioxide release and is going in the atmosphere. These are the greenhouse gases. Huge quantity they are emitting, and they absorb the heat from the sunlight and ongoing heat, and the temperature is increased, and you know what are the impact. In Jhulbet, nothing to be purchased from them. No single gram of the FOM, no single gram of the cow dung manure, no single gram of the compost, vermicompost, even we are not utilizing any chemical fertilizer. We are not burning the biomass. That means we have totally stopped the emission of the creation greenhouse gases. And if the government of India has given the commitment in Copenhagen summit that government of India will reduce 23% carbon emission, how? They have to stop chemical farming. They have stopped organic farming, and only remedy to continue.